Venkat Gite, professor in Health Department of Urology. As the World Incontinence Week is going on, I want to give a message for the society regarding the overactive bladder. So first of all, we will see what is meant by overactive bladder. The component of overactive bladder is urgency, urge incontinence, and nocturia and frequency. These are the core components. So what is meant by frequency? If the person is going more than 8 times in a day, then that is called as a frequency. As per World Incontinence Society, if a person is going more than one time or once also, it is called as a nocturia. And if a person has to go urgently to pass the urine, then that is called as urgency. While going to the urination, if he is leaking in between on the way, then that is called as urge incontinence. These all four symptoms will affect the quality of life, and it has impact on social outcast, as well as it may end up into the depression of that particular person. So reason for what are the causes of overactive bladder? So the overactive bladder may be due to urinary tract infections, allergies, stress, and lifestyle. It may also result into the overactive bladder. So if such symptoms are seen and if they are not going for a long period of time, then one has to go for one has to go to see the urologist to confirm the diagnosis and evaluating the problems and starting the treatment. So what are the things which mimics with the overactive bladder? So urinary tract infection, stone, tuberculosis, bladder pain syndrome, or malignancies. So to diagnose the overactive bladder, what are the things to do is voiding diary, ultrasound, urinary examination, history, and clinical examination. So what to do if it is overactive bladder? First of all, it needs behavioral changes or lifestyle changes. This is the first step. If it is not responding to the lifestyle changes, then medication. If it is not responding to medication also, then finally a botulinum toxin or surgery. So we will see what is meant by lifestyle changes. First, person has to try to hold the urine for as long as possible to increase the bladder capacity to hold the urine. And to de-stress the mind, one has to do exercises, one has to talk with the friends, and one has to engage himself or herself into the hobbies to overcome upon the urgency or symptoms of the overactive bladder. As far as exercises is concerned, the pelvic floor exercises, or it is called as Kegel exercises, that can be taught. Once it is taught, it can be done at home, and they are very easy to do it. So there are 10, 20, 25, 100 times also it can be done. It is very easy. And in spite of behavioral changes and the perineal exercises, if it is not coming down, the symptoms were not coming down, then we have to take the help of the medication, which should be prescribed by the urologist. So medications is to decrease the sensation of urine and increase the storage capacity of the bladder, we have to calm the mind also. So what are the medications? That medications may be the medications were anticholinergic drugs, and there are n number of anticholinergic drugs available in the market. So if in spite of that, physical exercises, pelvic floor exercises, and medication, if it is not responding, then one has to take the help of endoscopic botulinum toxin, as well as if required, and if it is fit, then one can take the help of the surgeons. So what are the changes to be done in routine day-to-day food? The food recommended is for the such type of patients were low acidic fruits like banana, apple, and grapes, fiber rich foods like lentils, beans, and vegetables, that is cucumber, carrot, and broccoli, and protein rich food is the egg, fish, and chicken. So all such type of foods is to be recommended in patient of overactive bladder. So what not to take? So caffeinated drinks like coffee and tea, which increases the symptoms, these are the urgency and urge incontinence. So caffeinated drinks should be avoided. Another thing is spicy foods and milk products, which causes irritation of bladder and increases the chances of spasm of the bladder should be avoided. Alcohol should be stopped because it act as a diuretic and it increases the urine, so alcohol should not be taken. Sugar, honey and artificial flavors or sweeteners should be avoided because it irritate the bladder. So finally, one has to take care of your overactive bladder by change in the behavior or lifestyle changes. 1, 2, perineal exercises. 3, drugs. These are the anticholinergic drugs. 4, these are the endoscopic treatment in terms of the botulinum toxin. And 5th, if it is surgery required, essentially, absolutely required, then surgery. So these are the 4 to 5 pillars in management of the overactive bladder. As the pandemic is, COVID-19 pandemic is going on, I must say, okay, stay home and stay safe.